Multiple myeloma is totally changed in last year. The clinical panorama, but also the deep understanding of biology of multiple myeloma, of the heterogeneity of disease, is really giving like a revolution in not only in results, so in clinical results, but also in the diagnostic of multiple myeloma. We will realize a great session about multiple myeloma, in which I'm honored to chair with Professor Kenneth Anderson and with the Prof. Marie-V Mateos, in which we will try to recall the preclinical and clinical history of this disease. And in particular, we want to try to collocate the new drugs in a new paradigm, a new therapeutic sequence, because at the moment the problem is that we have many drugs, many combinations, many mechanisms of action, but the real difficulty of multiple myeloma at the moment is to select which patients could benefit more from that drug. We are going towards a world in which we will have too many drugs, too many combinations, and maybe the most difficult will be to decide which is the best for that patient. We are really going in a new world, because if we think that only maybe 5 years ago we had so few drugs available, we could think about a possibility in which we had the frontline approach, maybe a first and second relapse approach, then we started to use chemotherapy. At the moment, the panorama is changing. We have new generation proteasome inhibitors. We have many immunomodulating agents, and we are going deeply in monoclonal antibodies era, also in frontline treatment. There are some unmet clinical needs, in particular if with the daratumumab-based frontline approach, we will go in a new era in which we will not need the autologous stem cell transplantation. We are curious about the long-term data of daratumumab-based frontline approach, but we are also thinking about the patients we will relapse after a so long duration approach as daratumumab frontline regimens will be, as we are seeing from data. And that's why we need also totally new opportunities. And in particular, I think that belantamab and selinexor, isatuximab, and all new drugs which are coming in Europe will have a role for plurirelapsed patients. And in particular, I imagine also the patients who have been diagnosed in an old era of multiple myeloma who will have the opportunity to be treated also in plurirelapsed disease with the monoclonal antibody-based regimen. And I think that it will be important also to reevaluate some opportunities like elotuzumab in combination with pomalidomide and dexamethasone. And the quadruplets, I'm really curious about the changing from triplets to quadruplets. We want also to underline the heterogeneity in like in how they respond in multiple myeloma, and the need sometimes of totally different mechanism of action, such as chemotherapy. Some myeloma seem to be resistant to new agents, but to be really sensible to chemotherapy. We want also to focus about the importance of maintenance after a frontline approach, and we know that now we have long-term frontline data in lenalidomide after single or tandem autologous stem cell transplantation. We want to underline this. We want to introduce new opportunities for maintenance treatment also for future, and we want to to recall all the actual history, multiple myeloma, which is going towards a future in which maybe the patients will have a duration of response of 10 years after frontline approach. And that's why we are dreaming what can be the future at the first relapse after a so productive, a so effective frontline approach. I think that at the moment, multiple myeloma is maybe the disease in which the research is having the best results in hematological malignancies if we consider not only what we have at the moment in our hands, but what is arriving, not only in the United States, but also in Italy. And also in multiple myeloma, we will share our knowledge comparing the state of the art in the United States, in all Europe, and in particular also in Italy, in order to understand what we lack, what the United States lack, and how we can really fix our knowledge and our opportunities in order to give the best approach in diagnosis and in treatments to our patients, independent from their geographic location. And also in multiple myeloma, we are aiming to write a recommendation paper coming from So Italy in order to fix this suggestion for the best preclinical and clinical approach to this disease. And in particular, we want to focus how much is important to deeply understand the biology at diagnosis, because the strange part of this disease is that the risk stratification of multiple myeloma is really old one, not biology driven, not molecular driven, but based on really old parameters. Our dream, our idea is to find new biomarkers and to rewrite the risk stratification of multiple myeloma. And we hope that So Italy and the faculty colleagues of this great event will help to design, to study new approach also for rewrite the risk stratifications of this particular previously bad prognosis disease, which is really improving thanks to novel agents, but in which we need more and more to deeply understand the biology in order to have a really target therapy, not based only on clinical results, but on the biology of the disease.